invite you to turn to page 2 of your worship bulletin and stand as you are able for the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, full of compassion and mercy, abounding in steadfast love.
Amen.
Trusting God's promise of forgiveness, let us confess our sin against God and against one another.
What is this place?
may be rooted in the way of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
First reading is from the book of Isaiah, from the 44th chapter. Thus says the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first, and I am the last. Besides me there is no God. Who is like me? Let them proclaim it. Let them declare and set it forth before me. Who has announced from of old things to come? Let them tell us what is yet to be. Do not fear or be afraid. Have I not told you from of old and declared it? You are my witnesses. Is there any God besides me? There is no other rock. I know not one. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read responsibly from Psalm 86. Teach me your way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth. Give me an undivided heart to revere your name.
Against thee, O God, and the man of
to anger and full of kindness and truth.
Turn to me and have mercy on me. Give your strength to your servant and save the child of your hand. Show me the sign of your favor so that those who hate me may see it and be ashamed. Because you, Lord, have helped me and not failed me.
The second reading is from the book of Romans, from the 8th chapter. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if in fact we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now, and not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, grown inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is at the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. Will you pray with me this morning? Lord God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, for you are our strength, our rock, and our Redeemer. Amen. One of the things that I like about moving to a new home is what is planted outside and discovering what comes up over the course of the year. When I moved to a new home in Maryland, the owners assured us that the gardens had been planted and there was an area with wildflowers and all sorts of stuff. At that point, it was the fall and it didn't look like much. But the next spring, things began to come up and I wanted to go out and weed the gardens, but I was afraid to because I wasn't exactly sure what was a weed and what would be a flower. So I left everything grow for that first year. And some things bloomed early and some during the mid-season and some late. And some things didn't bloom at all. And so I sort of thought they might be weeds. But because by fall I couldn't remember which plants had actually had flowers earlier on, I decided not to do any more weeding. So the next spring came, and I discovered that some of the things that had not bloomed the year before bloomed that year. And what was that all about? I learned that there are some plants that are biennial. They only bloom every other year. So I was glad that I had not gone and randomly pulled things out because I thought they might be weeds. Now here, when we moved to Hickory, something similar happened, not quite the same. We had two hydrangea bushes, we still have them, and the first year we moved in August, so they had already come and gone. And so the fall came, and not knowing anything about hydrangeas, we decided to cut them off for the winter. And so the next spring, I see those of you who know about hydrangeas going. The next spring came and they grew up and got nice and bushy, but there were no flowers. And so I thought, well, it must have been that late freeze that we had that froze the blossoms and therefore they didn't bloom. So that fall came and we cut them down again. And the next spring came and they got nice and bushy again, and still no flowers. My husband said, I'm going to just rip those things out. And I said, no, let's give them another year. And so this time, I actually talked to somebody who had lovely hydrangeas in their yard. And I found out that hydrangeas bloom on the second year's growth. So by cutting them down in the fall, we had successfully cut down what would have been blooming the following year. So that year we did not cut them down in the fall, and indeed in the springtime we have lovely, lovely hydrangeas. and sows weeds in with the wheat. Now, it was probably something called darnel, which looks similar to wheat when it grows up. When the servants discovered that there were weeds in with the wheat, they went to the householder and said, "Didn't you sow good seeds here?" And the householder said, "Yes." And they said, "Well, where did all these weeds come from?" And the householder said, "An enemy did it." Now imagine with me if you are one of the early listeners to this parable. And you hear a parable about a person sowing seed and an enemy coming and sowing weeds. We've got good things and we have bad things. It sort of sets up this dichotomy in the world that we would like very much to be able to see. Wouldn't it be easy if everything was either red and yellow, or black and white, good and bad? Wouldn't that be easy if that were the case? But sometimes you can't tell. I know that from my little experience gardening. Sometimes you don't know what's a weed and what's a flower. And sometimes what you know to be a flower doesn't bloom. And sometimes the things that you think are weeds bloom the following year. Now there is a little bit of a problem with any sort of an analogy or metaphor like the one that Jesus used. Because it's limited. He explains it and says that the householder, the owner, is the Son of Man. The ground is the world, the field is the world. The good seed are the children of God, the children of heaven, those good people. And the evil one is the devil, and the weeds are the children of the devil, those who do evil things. And that's great as far as it goes. But if we're honest with ourselves, we know that inside each and every one of us is a little bit of heaven and a little bit of the other place. We know that there's good and evil inside of all of us. Martin Luther said that we are simultaneously saint and sinner, simul justus et peccator in Latin. And he said that we are justified by our faith in Christ Jesus, that Christ Jesus died for us, and that through Christ Jesus we have forgiveness from God. But just because we are forgiven, that doesn't make us holy and perfect people in this world. Because you see, there is still sin, there is still the devil who is present, there is still the evil that sometimes traps us. But God is stronger than any of that. Thanks be to God. This parable, I think, tells us several things. One is that sometimes the good and the bad, the wheat and the tares or the darnel, must grow together. Because if you start yanking out the weeds, you're going to pull out the wheat as well. Now, wouldn't we like to whenever that is. And until then, all of the roots are intertwined, and sometimes the people that we would write off as horrible people, well, God isn't done with them yet. They might be late bloomers. They might be people who come around. And those who are seemingly absolutely marvelous, well, we know people who have been found out later in life to have done horrible things that were hidden. It is not ours to judge. And we can be thankful for that, because it is God's to do that. And because God's going to do that, we can worry about and work on the little corner of the world that we have, namely ourselves. And we can try to live as children of God in the best way possible. We can try to witness to God's love to everyone, no matter what we think of them, because only God knows what's inside everybody's heart. So today, I invite you to consider putting aside judgment, because it isn't ours to do anyway, and to do your best, and I'll do my best, to share God's love and God's compassion and God's forgiveness with everybody. Because I believe that love and compassion and forgiveness is the good fertilizer that sometimes can make things bloom and grow that you wouldn't think could happen. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able to sing hymn number 508.
Thank you.
abundance and variety of plants and trees and fruits and vegetables and grains that grow in the world that you have created. We thank you for giving these things to us to care for, and we pray that you would guide us in our own stewardship of creation and all that you have given us. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. Lord, in your mercy. your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our risen Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please take some time and share God's peace.
Thank you.
captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
Send your spirit of truth, O God, rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love for the sake of a world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and hear us as we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
May God, power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine, grant you the gifts of faith and hope. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen.
Our sending song is actually hymn number 809. That's 809. Same words as the one that's posted, "Send me Jesus," but slightly different. So hymn number 809.
Thank you. Hello.
I didn't get a chance to say peace be with you. You are? Who gave you permission?
I think I need you.
Where you going?
You are getting to Sunday.
No, you're not crazy. I lived a long time.
But I'm told to play to everyone. So,
have a marvelous time. Stay cool. Their place has air conditioning, right?
Oh, hey, okay. Good. How are you?
Good.
Take care. Let go back here. Okay.
Yeah, I get him.
I got him. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I almost forgot to get mine out. It was in the car. Thank you. I'm so glad to be here. I'm so sorry that I don't get here sometimes. Sometimes I get up and I'm throwing up and all that. It's like,
yep. You'd come when you can.
Father, thank you.
Take care. Go out there and get some food and enjoy your grandson.
Almost afraid to
eat it. Almost afraid to eat it.
It's beautiful.
It is.
It's so pretty. Oh, my God.
That's cute. That tree had thorns everywhere. I was told I couldn't leave it up there. That thing's expensive. No, they're everywhere. They're everywhere. Yes, sure. And a couple of dollars give you a good one. Really good. That one, this one's a camera. It's got the camera. You can move the camera around.
It's cute.
Okay. It's not easy. I can't. I'm not saying you're not smart or I am, but I can't do it. I've done it twice. One time it was on top of my neighbor's house because I couldn't get it to. I get confused. And these young kids and stuff can do all that stuff, you know. I got confused where I was doing.
They are. But you got them on to the chairs.
You can get them all sides and stuff. You can even have it on your smartphone. Transfer to your smartphone. Or you can use your smartphone. Some of them have it. You start the smartphone as the remote control. Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. But I thought I was going to be good enough to do all that stuff. I tried. I was going to try to show off in front of my friend Tim. They'll fly and they'll go. I mean, they'll go. Really? Yeah, they'll take off. Them things, they're not as fast as maybe a straight airplane. But, you know, they can hover and sit there and hover. They can do flips.
Well, that's what this guy had on.
They're good. These guys are good, though. I mean, these guys, you don't want to use military. I watch Marines do their drone. Air Force Captain June. They were showing him all they can do. That stuff. He's just sitting there. He come down and zoom with somebody in the audience. Good up there. The camera's like ours. See, I can just like, let me cut this off.